there's a war going on outside, no man is safe from. You could run, but you can't hide forever from these streets that we done took. You walking with your head down, scared to look.
What's up, dudes? It's Dr. Steelhammer. Today we are learning advanced Urine techniques in a new 5-part series entitled Leaving Mongolia. We're getting one-way tickets on JetBlue from Ulaanbaatar to Tokyo. This series, when combined with the 5-Minute Murder series, will give you all the tools necessary to finally put away Super Smash Bros. Brawl, drop Luigi, pick up a stick of deodorant, and open a 401k, because we are learning old man games. Today we're going to learn the basics of charge partitioning through the dash headbutt, and then we're going to spend some time learning the basics of ping pong, various ping pongs, and then 100% combos. For the dum-dums in the room, partition in this context means to divide into parts. In Third Strike, you can split charges into multiple parts. As you can see here, after I drop the Aegis, I hold down for a split second. 1-2, I dash, and then I go 1, up and punch. That headbutt charge is split in between two because it's stored on the invisible charge meter. You never know where the charge meter is, so that's why it's valuable to try to reset it so you can get a clean slate. The easiest way to do that is to activate an Aegis. When an Aegis is activated, Super Flash resets the charge meter so I can do a standard charge partition without having to know the specifics of where the meter was before the first charge. You can see I split the charge into two parts. I know exactly where the meter is because I reset it by activating Aegis. Here's the finish of the ping pong. Let's get into the basics of how to do the ping pong and some of the more advanced techniques. This setup can be quick rise, that's why you want to change the release of the Aegis to fuck with their quick rise timing. The standard ping pong is crouch short, crouch medium kick, crouch jab, and then launch it. Let's try to figure out how I got that crouch short. You gotta walk back. Do the walk back before you hit the crouch short. Let the mirror hit and then crouch short. By letting the mirror hit, you allow Ryu to combo nicely into the crouch short, and it's a two-hit combo, which then turns into the full ping pong. If you crowd him and you stand too close, you won't get that proper bounce.
Buyakasha!
That's the standard ping pong and the standard ender, but there's way cooler things you can do. Check it out. The first ping pong works on everyone. This one only works on tall and medium height characters. Won't work on Makoto, Oro, Twins, the tiny little boys. This one is from Kuroda. It's unbelievably strong. It's just tighter. You use medium buttons and you can get more damage and more meter back. This ping pong is focused on stun. More stand medium punches, big heavy moves that end with stand medium punch EX headbutt. This one is if you want to keep the corner, it requires a reverse tackle. I'm going to make a similar video on how to do this reverse tackle, but most mid-screen ping pong should end with corner controlled. Against tall characters, you can kind of flex nuts. Look at that. Crouch short, stand medium, punch fierce, fireball. I mean, that's just rude. That is just disrespectful. This is my favorite way to get to the ping pong currently. It's off the jab and nago. They fall into it, and it's really, really consistent. You can also do it off of the standard mid-screen unblockable. It's not my first choice, but if everyone's parrying everything else, think about the walk back crouch short. The walk back crouch short is the secret to the ping pong. Like anything in Third Strike, your moves can be parried. If they parry the crouch short, you can dash forward into a launcher. You can chop to break guard high. You have options if they decide to block, and I don't recommend they try to block. It's much easier if they block for you to just dash through, break guard, launch, and a tackle. Ping pong also is required for certain 100% combos. The standard ping pong right there on Makoto allows for the 100% RKF setup. Ping pong is about creativity, but it's also about setting up these specific situations which allow for massive amounts of damage and stun, and each character juggles in different ways, so you have to kind of learn them. For Remy, if you do the flying Inago off of the launcher canceled into medium punch Aegis, jump roundhouse, double stand medium punch, crouch medium kick, stand medium punch, EX headbutt, headbutt, you can kill him in one touch. One touch, touch of death. Sometimes I touch myself and I wish I was dead. All right, this is a pretty cool version on Chun-Li. That specific ping pong is absolutely necessary if you want to create it, though you can't fool around and change things up. There are certain set sequences which create these environments. On Dudley, you do one stand medium punch off the flying Inago, and you're able to create a double Inago setup, but he bounces beautifully off of this mirror into a jump, medium kick, reset, stand medium punch, EX headbutt, 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 fuck you, Dudley. Quick recap of what we learned today. We learned about the importance of the charge partition, how we're able to split our charge into individual parts that build up into one full charge. We learned about the ability for us to reset our charge meter by activating an Aegis. We learned about the walk back crouch short and how that's the starter for most ping pongs. We also learned about choosing our specific ping pong based on whether or not we want stun or damage. And finally, the importance of learning specific ping pongs for each individual 100% combo and how we can't deviate from that if we want to create the perfect scenarios for ultimate death. Armed with this new knowledge, do you think you're going to be able to defeat the hordes of Mongolians?
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.